So now that you've got your DNA tested, what do you do? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and today I'm going to tell you about something that you can do once you've had your DNA tested. One of the purposes of testing your DNA is to be able to match other people who have similar DNA, and so probably are related to you in some way. However, if you test with AncestryDNA, you're going to be able to be matched with others who have tested with AncestryDNA. If you've tested with Family Tree DNA, you're going to be able to match with others who have tested with Family Tree DNA. The problem is, you can't be matched with somebody from a different company unless you do something first. So each of the major companies offers you the ability to download your raw DNA data file. Now, that sounds a little bit complicated, but it's not. So let me walk you through the steps that you need to do in order to download your file and now be able to share it with other companies. So here we are on the Ancestry website. And if you go into your profile and go under DNA, and you want to go to your DNA results summary, click on that. And it's going to pop up all of the information, the ethnicity settings, the matches that you have. But what we want is we want over here in the settings. Now, this is not your overall ancestry settings. This is your ancestry DNA settings. So be aware if you don't see what's happening next, you're probably in the wrong settings. So we click on that settings, and it's going to give us this option over here to download our raw DNA file. And you can find out what it is, but basically, your raw DNA file is going to be a series of columns with numbers and letters in it. It's not going to make much sense to you. But that's okay because we're going to let the computer make all the sense of it. We want to click on Download our raw DNA data. Here it's going to have you enter your password again, and then with Ancestry, it's going to email you a link that you can then click on to download that file. Once you download it, it's going to look like this. It's going to be a zip file. You can see that it is about 5.5 to 6 megabytes big. It's really quite a big file. Whatever you do, don't try to unzip this. Just leave that file exactly the way it is because you're going to upload that file how it was downloaded to you. Now, if we go over to 23andMe, I can show you where you can be able to download your DNA from 23andMe. So with 23andMe, once we've logged in, we're going to come to the home page. And again, it has all of the information we need. And if you remember with Ancestry, we went to the DNA settings. Well, in this case, we're not going to go over here to the settings, so don't click over here. What we want is we want the tools. Under tools, there is Browse Raw DNA Data. We want to click on that. So with the browsing the raw data, it's going to have us opt in first. This is just the first time you do it. All the other times, you're not going to have to do this. Now, once you're in your browsing the raw data, you'll notice that it has an option to also download the data. That's what we want. We want to download the data. Now, when we download the data, this tells you exactly what that file is going to look like. It's going to be a zip text file from 5 megabytes to 30 megabytes large, just like you got from Ancestry. If you actually open it up, it's going to look something like this, but we're not going to open it up. We scroll down to the bottom, and with 23andMe, you have the option of downloading all of your data. You have the option of downloading just the Y chromosome or just the mitochondrial DNA. Then you'll have to enter your password again and be able to download the data. We're not going to do that for right now because we already got this file from Ancestry. And we're going to use this file from Ancestry and upload it to another location. So if we go over on the internet to GEDmatch. Now, GEDmatch is a free website that can aggregate actually DNA results from all these different companies. So if you've tested Ancestry or 23andMe or Family Tree DNA, you can upload your results to GEDmatch and be able to match with others from different companies. And so not only are you be able to match with those in the company you tested with, but you're also able to match with everybody else who's uploaded the results to GEDmatch. There is also some tools that you can pay for, but again, the initial uploading and being able to match is free. When you log in, it's really a bare bones website. There's not a lot of fancy graphics or anything. So if you're not used to that, then really it might take a bit to poke around and get used to. In this case, what we want is we want the generic upload fast because we have an ancestry file. Now, if you have a 23andMe, you want to do the 23andMe fast and easy. There's a couple of warnings here. Do not open or unzip your raw DNA data files. So like I said, don't open them. If you want to open them, then what I would do is I would make a copy of that zip and then open up that copy. In this case, we're going to upload this. And so what we have is we just have a raw DNA file, which is a record. We need to attach some information to that so that others can find it. And then in this case, you're going to be attaching your name. You're going to have your account that's attached to it. If you know your haplogroups from your mitochondria or your Y DNA, then you can add those as well. In this case, this is my wife's. So I'm going to put her on here. And she doesn't have an alias. I know that she's female. As we come down here, it says to please acknowledge that you authorize this data to be made available for comparisons in our database. If you click no, it won't be able to be compared. And there's really no point in uploading it if you're not going to be comparing it on GEDmatch. So we want to click that to yes. And then we have where we find it. So we're going to browse. You're going to click on the zip file. And you can see here that I found that DNA zip file. And then we're going to upload it. Now this will take a couple of minutes and you'll be able to see on the screen what's happening is the computer system is uploading that file and then it's going to open up the zip file and unpack all of the information to make sure it's all there. So you can see it's going right now, it's processing the chromosomes from 1 through 22 and the X chromosome. And this may take a little bit, but once we have this done, then GEDmatch has your information and it's going to assign you a number. You can write this number down, but if you know what your login is, it's going to be there on the home screen. I'll show you here in just a second. So it's completed now. We're able to compare ourselves now with others. So let's go and take a look at how we can compare. So this is the home screen again, and you can have several different kits registered. So if you look right here, here is the kit that was just registered, Devin Lee. A117522. And you can see there's others. You can have multiple for the same people. For instance, there's myself with my ancestry kit. And then down here is myself with my 23andMe kit. Now, what you want to do to initially be able to is this is going to have two asterisks, which means that there's still some processing that needs to be done. So it's available if you're comparing it one to one, but if you want to have it compared one to many, you're going to have to wait a few days for that to be completed. So I'm going to show you what the comparison looks like with the one to many using my 23andMe kit. We go up here to analyze your data, and you can go through any of these, and I'm just going to go through the one to many real quick. It gives you an option to enter the kit or select it from the dropdown. So I'm just going to enter that kit number. The autosomal, you can select how close of a match you want to be able to display. It's going to default to 7, which is all right. In this case, I'm actually going to raise it up to 10. And so that's going to have to be more closely related people that it's going to be able to match to. And this is then what pops out. And so you can see here, if you just look at this, is we have myself. We have my parents. They're the next two people that it's finding is the next most closely related to me. Then there is my grandparents, which are also very closely related to me. And then after that is all the other people that have information in GEDmatch that are being matched. Now, MyHeritage has a way that you can also upload your DNA file from some of the other companies to it. I'm not gonna go through that, but it's a very similar process. And FamilyTreeDNA, you can also upload your DNA files to their website. Now, FamilyTreeDNA, it does cost a little bit for all of the tools that they have, but they have the free initial match that I think it gives you 5 or 10 matches of the best matches that you have. So once you've gotten your DNA tested, you want to make sure that you can match with as many people as possible. And in order to do that, you need to be in as many databases as possible. So download your raw DNA file, upload it to GEDmatch and upload it to MyHeritage and to FamilyTreeDNA. Thanks for watching Family History Fanatics. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, just put them in the comments below and give us a like and subscribe to our channel.